Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and all of the sponsors of the Rhode Island Uniform Parentage Act. Thank you, Leader Shikarchi, Chairman Craven, Representative Caldwell, and especially thank you, Representative McEntee, for all of your work shepherding this bill. I remember, Representative McEntee, that we first talked about it before I was even elected to the House. This bill is important to me and to my family, and not just to families like mine with two moms, but to so many Rhode Island families. We haven't updated our family law around who is a parent in 40 years. A lot has happened at that time. Families come in all sorts of configurations, and science has come a long way to help families struggling with infertility. I'm really glad that Representative Filippi brought up surrogacy, children born into families who had medical help to get pregnant through artificial reproductive technology and through surrogacy deserve a legal framework to protect their rights. And this bill does that. It makes sure that babies have their intended parents recognized from the very beginning. That helps with family stability, security, and things like child support responsibility if that's necessary. My partner Joanna and I have two beautiful children, 14 and 11 years old. We are grateful that we were able to hire lawyers to help us navigate adopting the children one of us had birthed. This legislation, had it been enacted then, would have greatly reduced the barriers to protecting our family from a start. At a time when we had plenty of other things to juggle as two working mamas with one and then two babies. I have to say, I had forgotten all of the hoops we jumped through in order to establish legal parentage for our children. But hearing the testimony on this bill reminded me that we went through DCYF, fingerprinting, home visits, the courts. I'm pretty sure I had to get a letter from my doctor that I was healthy enough to be a parent. For many, these hoops are insurmountable barriers, leaving children vulnerable. Listening to the testimony, I was reminded how stressful it is to live in uncertainty because I had lived in that uncertainty about who had legal rights to take care of our children. And I just want to say to all of us today, our vote to pass this important legislation, because of our vote, people who intended to parent a child will be legally recognized from the start through a simple voluntary acknowledgement of parentage. And I want to talk for a minute also about COVID and the uncertainties of COVID, because this bill is related to that too. It has really brought home the anxiety for families where parents aren't yet legally recognized. The family courts were closed and everything slowed down, and the anxiety around what if something happens to one of us is a little more real these days. One of the Rhode Island families working so hard on this bill was hit by COVID early on. Elena and Denise are both healthcare workers. And Elena, a doctor in emergency room, tested positive for COVID, and soon the whole family was sick. Thankfully, they have recovered, and maybe you read their op-ed. Every family worries about what if something happens to one of us, or if neither of us can take care of our children. But the additional worry about whether our relationships with our children are even legally recognized is an added stress that we here are fixing today. For real families like Elena and Denise, and like Meredith and Andy, who are expecting a child this fall and worried about what happens if the courts are closed, and COVID means the adoption process will take even longer. The amendment is going to make this even more real and help even more people right away. Parents like Meredith and Andy will soon have their legal relationship with their child affirmed right at birth, protecting everyone. It's not easy for us to share our stories about fear and inequity, and I'm so grateful for the willingness of so many parents to bring their little ones to the Statehouse to tell their stories about why this legislation is so important. The coalition that formed Rhode Islanders for Parentage Equality worked hard to make sure that their stories were heard. And I'm sure many of them are watching right now. Thank you. And to the advocates and lawyers who spent so many hours working on the substance of the bill, Patience Crozier, and to all the other lawyers and experts who worked to draft the Uniform Parentage Act, including my college classmate, Courtney Jocelyn, thank you. We need to be able to protect our children and families, and this bill provides an updated framework for Rhode Island. It's the first update to our parentage laws in many decades. It's a great bill. Thank you, Representative McEntee, and everyone who put in so much energy on this. I hope you will all join me in voting for this great bill. Thank you.